Today on Warrior Update, a congressman visits the Warriors, Waubonsie honors its student scholars, and we go over Tribe Time's do's and don'ts. It's Friday, February 8th. I'm Matt Despain, and this is Warrior Update. Waubonsie recognized student scholars last Wednesday. Warrior Update reports.
Waubonsie Valley celebrated its Indian Prairie Scholars on Wednesday night in the auditorium. 254 students were recognized for their work over the course of their high school career. In addition, 81 teachers were recognized as distinguished educators, as chosen by student scholars. An Indian Prairie Scholar is a distinction defined as any student receiving a 3.6 cumulative GPA over the previous 7 semesters of their high school career. In addition, Illinois State Scholars were also recognized, as any students that performed in top half of their graduating class or scoring in the 95th percentile on the ACT or the PSAE. The event included musical and performances and a candle lighting ceremony to signify the passing of knowledge. Also, 1999 graduate Tamara Wilson, who was selected as the distinguished alumnus, spoke to the students. For a list of honored students and teachers, visit WaubonsieMedia.com. For Warrior Update, I'm Robert Cohen.
Washington, D.C. came to Aurora this Monday. Warrior Update has more.
For one day, the government came to students, as Illinois' 11th District Congressman Bill Foster visited Waubonsie Valley. The congressman held a Q&A with students and gave them insight into his political life.
It was really kind of a cool experience to see somebody in such high power and just like talk to us like we were, like he's a teacher and just educating us on what it's like being him.
The experience brought government to light for students.
We asked him some far off topics and he always brought it in to made it seem more real for us, I think, and just kind of the how we are actually affected, like each of us, instead of just, oh, I think of politics and I don't even think of myself as a part of it, but he kind of brought it into the school, I thought.
I would definitely say it probably opened my eyes more to how politicians connect with us, like as students and just as people. I'm not really the type of person that get into all politics, but you know, it kind of just opened my eyes to see, you know, what's more out there. We're all politicians in a way, like, you know, it was kind of like freeing, like we can ask some questions. You're part of the group. He works with us. He's on our side. He works for the people.
For Warrior Update, I'm Nolan Castino.
Waubonsie is honoring an alumni this week. Warrior Update reports.
Waubonsie Valley introduced its 2019 Distinguished Alumnus on Wednesday night at the Indian Prairie Scholars Ceremony. Tamara Wilson is a 1999 graduate who has had a successful career as an opera soprano since 2007. She has performed in leading roles at the Canadian Opera Company, the English National Opera, the Houston Grand Opera, the Metropolitan Opera, and the Sydney Opera House.
I was in a car wash in Houston waiting for my car to get done, and Jason Schmidt called me, and he's like, "We're thinking about having you as a distinguished alumni." I was like, "Yes! Who says no to that?"
In her senior year at Waubonsie, Wilson was in plays, musicals, and swing choir. She was named Outstanding Senior in Theater and Music and won the Director's Award for Vocal Music.
High school for me was one of my happiest times, not gonna lie. From like swimming to swing choir to all the plays and stuff, I must have been here 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. every day. That's what it felt like.
Her message to students was that it's okay to strive for perfection, but to take the time to experience a lot and appreciate the little things about high school.
So I was definitely very goal-driven, very achievement-based. And then once I got to my master's, I realized, oh, I really haven't lived a life at all. And so I kind of was sad that I didn't get that opportunity while I was younger. So now that I see young people, I make sure that they enjoy the fun times too, not just the let's get this test done kind of time.
For Warrior Update, I'm Austin Rose.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
I Meg.
Second semester seniors.
Yeah, I'm kind of done with it already.
Let's get in trouble.
That's a Saturday school.
Oh no, a Saturday school.
As you may know, Waubonsie Valley is experimenting with a student academics guidance time this coming month. And as we're excited for this pilot program, there are a few things we want you to know and be prepared for in regard of expectations. Students should know that they'll be needing to report to a classroom, a quiet place to study, or a designated area during this time.
You can go here, here, and here.
Students could meet with a teacher, a counselor, a social worker, or maybe the principal. Students need to know that they need to arrive at their location on time and make sure they stay in that location for the 30-minute period without moving back and forth between locations. Students could report to the testing center to make up a quiz or a test that they had missed.
I just took a test.
And finally, most importantly, make sure you're not roaming the halls, in the atrium, or the stairwells during this period. Remember, Tribe Time is for you to connect with teachers and other support staff, so make sure you use this time wisely. Reporting for Warrior Update, this is your principal, Jason Stipp.
Boys basketball gets ready for primetime television this weekend. Warrior Update has more.
Waubonsie Valley boys basketball reached a season milestone last week at Neuqua Valley as the team won its 20th game of the year.
We knew it was a big conference game. We just wanted to win so bad. We were ready in the locker room. No one was talking. We just really focused and we just stuck to the game plan.
We actually didn't play too bad in the first half. The first time we played them, we weren't making shots. But in the second half, we stopped executing on offense and defense. And so we just talked about executing and moving the ball a little bit more.
Darian Porter led the way with 18 points, and Marcus Skeet tallied 12 points as the Warriors avenged an earlier loss to Neuqua back in December.
I think we were just mentally ready to play today, and we weren't overhyping it in our head. You know, a lot of times we at our school tend to overhype the Neuqua game or overhype something and kind of get ourselves in a mental funk. But today we weren't doing that, and we were ready to go. It's about the kids, I think. I'm really happy for them. They've just bought into what we're doing. And because of that, I'm really proud of them and I'm thankful that they've bought in. And, you know, now we have to go out and execute and, you know, keep it going.
The Warriors defeated Oswego this week and now move on to Saturday when they host Oswego East on live television during primetime on Comcast Network 100. Tip-off is scheduled for 7:30 p.m. at WV's main gym. For Warrior Update, I'm Rosie Schrader.
That's all for Warrior Update. I'm Matt Despain. Thanks for watching. What do you like, Karina? Boys basketball has primetime television this week.
Matt,
do you still see my tie? Slow, it sounds dead. Then I go fast, it's like...
I wanna get away.